Welcome back, everybody, to another Q&A with Dr. Jay Dunn of My Happy Genes. We are here to answer questions about genetics. And one of the questions that we've heard out in the world, because it is the it supplement of the week, is creatine. How do we know if it's going to do any good for us? Do we get is there like a lack of creatine in our body that's directed from a gene? Like, what's the deal?
Yeah, it's a good question because I get a little annoyed at these cure-all kinds of supplements. You go, oh my God, it does amazing things. And it does, but your body naturally produces it. And so the take home here is that if you get the body doing what it's supposed to do, and that is methylation, when you methylate correctly, and that's, those are biochemical processes in the body turned on by B12 and folic acid. And our body, when it activates those two nutrients, 75% of those methyl groups create creatine. And creatine is the main fuel for muscles and brain. And so people start to take creatine and they go, oh my gosh, I got all this energy and my brain turned on. And that tells me you're not methylating. If you're not methylating, there's lots of other things happening downstream that aren't happening and you're bypassing a pathway. So I'm a purist that way. I want the body making it. And so that's one way to tell if you're not methylating correctly, if you get a good response from creatine. And then the other way to tell if you're not methylating is histamine. If your histamine levels are high and you're reacting to pollen, et cetera, there are gene variants like the histamine N-methyltransferase that requires methylation for it to work to break down histamine. One of the ways that we tell on blood work that you're a low methylator is through blood histamine, whole blood histamine. If you see that on your blood work, and that's one of the things that we test for in the blood work with the MyHappyGenes panel. And so that's what they call pathognomonic for low methylation. In other
Can
words,
you say that again?
pathognomonic.
Pathognomonic. I love it.
Yeah. Which means that the only thing that causes high whole blood histamine is low methylation. So it's like a bunch of things would cause that. It's some simple ways that you can tell whether you're methylating or not. And it's not just that MTHFR gene.
It's not.
Well, no, it turns out there are a bunch of different genes that can lead to low methylation, including the DHFR, the dihydrofolate reductase, the methylene tetrahydrofolate dehydrogenase enzyme. That's a mouthful.
Easy for you to say.
And the methylene tetrahydrofolate reductase, which is the mother
Flipper.
flipper,
There you go.
which is the most commonly studied one, but it isn't the only one. MTRR gene, there's PEMT. There's lots of genetic variants in the methylation pathway that can lead to low creatine. And so again, getting your genes tested and looking at, there are certain companies that only test MTHFR and they only test MTRR, but if you have some of these others, it can interfere as well. And try some creatine. And if you feel better, you're not methylating correctly.
If you feel nothing, I have a friend, she said, I started taking it, the New York Times said, blah, blah, blah. I don't know if it's working. So keep
Probably
taking it or get your genes tested and
get your
find
genes
out.
tested, and you probably aren't don't have a problem in the methylation pathways. You're already producing it. So it's
I
not,
gotcha.
yeah. To me, it's a waste of money. And I know a lot of people, a lot of athletes use it to pump up their energy and their workouts. And that's a whole different scenario. But for the average person who's wanting to take something to pump their energy, it's, I think, short-sighted.
It sounds similar to protein. We hear all the time protein is the most important building block of muscle or whatever, but is it creatine or protein?
You need both to build muscle, but creatine is more the fuel and
Okay.
protein is the raw building blocks.
Okay.
But yeah, if you aren't methylating, you're going to be low in energy and low in brain energy and low in muscle energy. And one of the ways that we knew the first things that we saw when we started methylating people was memory, like the word recall would come back pretty quickly within a few days of starting their programs. That thing where you're like, what's that four leg? Oh, dog. That started to go away very quickly. They're like, oh yeah, I'm remembering people's names again and remembering facts that I had forgotten, or usually it's short term, but that was one way that we knew that they were methylating correctly. Brain function was coming on, and that was largely from the creatine that they were creating.
Well, it's so interesting. All of this genetic stuff to me is just fascinating, and how much we know now that we didn't know 10 years ago.
And it's more than just the genetics, it's the biochemistry that's
Yeah, true.
the magic behind it.
Yeah.
So that's what kind of led me to this company and to starting this company was the lack of companies that do look at the biochemistry that is affected by the genes. And that's a whole different scenario.
Everything is biochemistry.
It's all biochemistry.
Right. We are just a little biochemistry machine walking around with things happening and hormones talking to one another and enzymes making decisions and
Yeah, people don't realize that. And they're like, oh, biochemistry. It's like, oh my God, it's fun. I hated it when I
I
studied it.
remember you said that you went back and took it though when you got excited about it.
I did. Because when they were teaching it, it was very dry. It was like all arrows and ways. And I didn't understand what they were talking about or what it meant to me or to the body or to health. So I've learned to love it because now I understand it and I can work with it and upregulate it and change people's lives. And that's really fun.
Oh gosh, yeah. Yeah, that's got to be the best feeling in the world.
Yeah, it's very cool.
And you and our practitioners are doing it every dang day, changing people's lives, really. The simplest thing for me that I've learned from you, and there are many different things you've worked on, but the histamine thing was such a relief to find out that methylation, a few other things, don't eat salt, right? Like all work together for good, and I have a whole different outlook on summer and spring and fall. Pretty much the only time it was okay was winter. But no, really, it's made a huge difference in my life. So I encourage anybody who's listening who is interested in feeling better, if you have anything going on, I would head over to myhappygenes.com and get yourself a test.
Sounds good.
All right, people, we will be back again with we got a few good subjects coming up in the near future. So stop back here regularly so you don't ever miss a single episode. We
Perfect.
will see you again soon, Dr. J.
Okay, thanks, GC. Appreciate you.
You're welcome. Thank you.